Una sa lahat, no? Whether we become more active in rotational deployment in Bajo de Masinloc, or whether we are not deploying our own vessels in Bajo de Masinloc, there are always China Coast Guard vessels in those areas. Ngayon, ang dahilan, bakit natin ginagawa ito ngayon, no? Based on our engagement with the Filipino fishermen, they were saying that in those instances that there are Coast Guard or BFAR vessels in the vicinity of Bajo de Masinloc, mas nakakapangisda sila ng malaya. Dahil ang mga Chinese Coast Guard, they are more concerned on the presence of the government vessels ng Philippine government instead of harassing them. So ibig sabihin, mas natutulungan natin silang kami na lang ang pag-ubusan nyo ng panahon, hindi yung mga Pilipino mga isda. Ngayon, to answer your question, are we provoking China? Are we escalating it? I don't think so. You know, their presence with or without the government vessels, rotational deployment of PCG and BFAR vessels in Bajo de Masinloc, nando naman sila. The only reason why we're there, let me first highlight the fact na ang objective natin dito is not to provoke anybody, not to escalate the tension in Bajo de Masinloc. Our objective here is to protect the Filipino fishermen, to make sure na ang mga Pilipino maing isda ay makakapangisda sa Bajo de Masinloc. Dahil even before the presence of the Chinese Coast Guard in Bajo de Masinloc, ilang henerasyon na ng mga maing isda ng taga Sambales, Pangasinan, ang pumupunta rito. So ito ngayon ang objective ng ating Pangulo, to make sure that the government vessels will see to it na ang mga Pilipino maing isda, itutuloy pa rin ang pangisdaan dito to support our food security.
For the gentleman, no, sabi nga nila, carry a big stick. Are we getting bigger boats? Are we getting bigger boats? Number one. Number two, okay, in case na magkaroon ng open conflict o pasokin tayo, are we ready for that? Kasi sigurado dyan ang una si Galot kung gagaling sa fisheries vessels nila, hindi sa Great Great Ships nila.
These guys are cowards. Well, to be fair with our national government, in support of the Senate and Congress, and of course the current president now, President Bongbong Marcos, he has been very supportive of the modernization of the armed forces of the Philippines and also for the acquisition of additional vessels for the Philippine Coast Guard and even the Bureau of Fisheries and Aquatic Resources. So in terms of the capability development of our government assets, in maintaining our presence in the West Philippine Sea, we have been getting so much support for us to intensify our capability. Now, to the second question, are we prepared for war or something, a kinetic conflict that you're mentioning? You know, we go back to our constitution. War is something that we cannot, we don't use as an option to settle any issue. But, you know, ang national government po natin ngayon, obviously, I have to be very honest with you. If you're going to go head-to-head with the armed force, with the military of China and our armed force, the Philippines, which still being modernized, again, with the support of the national government. Of course, in terms of ratio, they are powerful than us. But again, that's not how we define our strategy in the West Philippine Sea. This is the very reason why we reach out to our allies, friends, and other like-minded states. No, we have already established a lot of defense cooperation with other countries. It's not about, you know, going head-to-head for a conflict with all these forces of China. We believe that the more established defense cooperation with more countries to support our cause, to support the arbitral ruling, to make sure that China will abide to the international law and respect to the arbitral award, is the objective why we are reaching out to the other countries. Again, there are diplomatic ways for us to make sure that the tension will eventually go down in the West Philippine Sea. We don't intend to provoke anybody. As much as possible, we de-escalate the tension, although, again, we are on the receiving end and they are the one escalating it.
Commander, as late as 2 years ago, sikat na sikat yung word na provocation eh. As if tayong nagtatanggol sa teritoryo. ang nagpo-provoke pa doon sa intruder. Sa tingin nyo ba, as a Filipino, kayo kasi, kayong nasa frontline eh, kataksilan sa isang Pilipino mag-isip na yung pagtatanggol sa sariling teritoryo ay provocation?
Well, mula sa lahat, sir, no? Ang let us first qualify kung ano yung sinasabi nating pagtatanggol sa teritoryo. Or, you know. But let us define, no? Our strategy right now is more of transparency for the entire Filipino people to be aware of what's happening in the West Philippine Sea. And the other objective is for the international community to be aware of what's happening. Siguro para sa akin, right now, ang issue lang naman natin are those Chinese sympathizers, pro-China sympathizers, na they produce an alternative story and, you know, instead of supporting our own factual narrative, there are people, no, or certain groups na imbis na tayo ang paniwalaan, imbis na sa statement ng ating national government ng suportahan. Ang sinusuportahan nila is yung statement ng China. For example, itong insidente na to, sabihin natin nangyari, i-deny ng China. And there are people na sinasabi nilang ang kwento ng China ang mas kapanipaniwala, ang kwento ng Pilipinas ang hindi. Iyon para sa akin ang mas nakakalungkot. Again, our strategy now in the West Philippine Sea is to provide transparency. And if you are not supporting the transparency and embracing the lies of China, I think that's the proper word that you describe it, sir.
At Commodore Tariela po. Sir, ako po si JC po from TV5. Sir, para lang po clear dun sa storytelling. Tama po, no? Noong Feb 8 to 13, wala pang na-monitor na floating barrier doon sa Bajo de Masinloc. Then, nung mission nung Feb 15, nung BRP tablot, doon na merong inilagay. Tama po ba?
Yes.
Okay. Sir, ano pong message yung, what is the message that China is trying to say with the installation na kada may deployment nga ng vessel, meron silang nilalagay na floating barrier? Ano po yung mensahe po kaya nila?
Well, to be honest with you, there's something that we are still evaluating, no? There's an observation that we have yet to forward to the National Task Force West Philippine Sea. So right now, I don't want to speculate or to give a specific definition of why they're doing this. But the reason why I mentioned this kanina is for everybody, for all of us, to note the fact that this is the strategy of China. As to how, as to why, again, I don't want to speculate yet. We have to refer this to the proper agencies to explain kung ano ang dahilan ng China, bakit nila ginagawa ito.
Tapos sir, on that same day, Feb 15, 25 times yung radio challenges. Tama
yes.
Po? Okay. Sir, patanong lang din po ng office. Tuloy daw po ba yung another paglalayag na ating co-coalition sa West Philippine Sea, yung second attempt? Or can you talk po on that?
Right now, as far as the national government is concerned and the Philippine Coast Guard is concerned, we still don't have the official communication requesting for ating ito coalition to do the same convoy, no? And whether in different parts of the West Philippine Sea, we still don't know.